A line goes through the points negative 1, comma 6, and 5, comma negative 4. What is the equation of the line? So let's just try to visualize this. So that is my x-axis. And you don't have to draw it to do this problem, but it always helps to visualize. That is my y-axis. And the first point is negative 1, comma 6. So negative 1, comma 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's this point right over there. That's negative 1, comma 6. And the other point is 5, comma negative 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we go down 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's right over there. And so the line that connects them will look something like this. The line will draw a rough approximation. I could draw a straighter line than that. I'll draw a little dotted line, maybe. Easier to do dotted lines. So the line will look something like that. So let's find its equation. So a good place to start is we could find its slope. Remember, we can find equation y is equal to mx plus b. This is the slope-intercept form, where m is a slope and b is a y-intercept. We can first try to solve for m. We could find the slope of this line. So m, or the slope, is the change in y over the change in x. Or we could view it as the y values of our endpoint minus the y value of our starting point over the x values of our endpoint minus the x values of our starting point. Let me make that clear. So this is equal to change in y over change in x, which is the same thing as rise over run, which is the same thing as the y value of your ending point minus the y value of your starting point. This is the same exact thing as change in y. And that over the x value of your ending point minus the x value of your starting point. This is the exact same thing as change in x. And you just have to pick one of these as a starting point and one as the ending point. So let's just make this over here our starting point and make that our ending point. So what is our change in y? So our change in y, we started at y is equal to 6. We started at y is equal to 6, and we go down all the way to y is equal to negative 4. So this is right here. That is our change in y. You could look at the graph. You say, well, if I start at 6 and I go to negative 4, I went down 10. Or if you just want to use this formula here, it'll give you the same thing. We finished at negative 4. We finished at negative 4. And from that, we want to subtract 6. This right here is y2. This is our ending y. And this is our beginning y. This is y1. So y2, negative 4, minus y1, negative 6. Or negative 4 minus 6, that is equal to negative 10. And all that's doing is telling us to change in y. To go from this point to that point, we had to go down. Our rise was negative. We had to go down 10. That's where the negative 10 comes from. Now we just have to find our change in x. So we can look at this graph over here. We start at x is equal to negative 1, and we go all the way to x is equal to 5. So we start at x is equal to negative 1, and we go all the way to x is equal to 5. So it takes us 1 to get to 0, and then 5 more. So our change in x is 6. You can look at it visually there, or you could use this formula, same exact idea. Our ending x value is 5, and our starting x value is negative 1. 5 minus negative 1. 5 minus negative 1 is the same thing as 5 plus 1, so it is 6. So our slope here is negative 10 over 6, which is the exact same thing as negative 5/3. As negative 5 over 3. Divide the numerator and the denominator by 2. So we now know our equation will be y is equal to negative 5/3, that's our slope, x plus b. So we still need to solve for our y-intercept to get our equation. And to do that, we can use the information that we know, or we have several points of information, but we can use the fact that the line goes through the point negative 1, 6. You could use the other point as well. But we know that when x is equal to negative 1, so y is equal to 6. So y is equal to 6 when x is equal to negative 1. So negative 5/3 times x. When x is equal to negative 1, y is equal to 6. So we literally just substitute this x and y value back into this. And now we can solve for b. So let's see. This negative 1 times negative 5/3. So we get 6 is equal to positive 5/3 plus b. And now we can subtract 5 thirds from both sides of this equation. So we have subtract the left-hand side from the left-hand side and subtract from the right-hand side. And then we get, what's 6 minus 5 thirds? So that's going to be, let me do it over here. We could take a common denominator. So 6 is the same thing as, let me just do it over here. So 6 minus 5 over 3 is the same thing as 6 is 18 over 3 minus 5 over 3. That's what 6 is, 18 over 3. And this is just 13 over 3. So this is 13 over 3. And then, of course, these cancel out. So we get b is equal to 13 thirds. So we're done. We know the slope, and we know the y-intercept. The equation of our line is y is equal to negative 5 thirds x plus our y-intercept, which is 13 over 3. And we could write these as mixed numbers if it's easier to visualize. 13 over 3 is 4 and 1 third. So this y-intercept right over here, that's 0, 13 over 3, or 0, 4 and 1 thirds. And even with my very roughly drawn diagram, it does look like this. And the slope, negative 5 thirds, that's the same thing as negative 1 and 2 thirds. And you can see here, the slope is downward sloping. It's negative. And it's a little bit steeper than a slope of 1. It's not quite a negative 2. It's negative 1 and 2 thirds, if you were to write this as a negative, as a mixed number. So hopefully you found that entertaining.